Hello children, welcome to AIIMS India's online classes, biology session, transportation, the circulatory system, part 4. In the last class, we have studied about different blood vessels and circulation. So let us recall briefly. The blood vessels are mainly divided into two types, that is distributing blood vessels and collecting blood vessels. Distributing blood vessels are called arteries, collecting blood vessels are called veins. So here in this picture you can see important blood vessels. That is vena cavae, the posterior vena cavae, anterior vena cavae and posterior vena cavae. These two blood vessels collect the blood from different parts of the body and opens into right auricle. Okay, how many chambers? There are four chambers: right auricle, left auricle, right ventricle, left ventricle, isn't it? How many chambers are there? Are four chambers, left ventricle. Okay, so these are vena cavae or caval veins. Caval veins, they collect the deoxygenated blood from all parts of the body and opens into right auricle. The next important blood vessel, pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery. The pulmonary artery arises from the right ventricle. It carries the deoxygenated blood from right ventricle to lungs. It is having two trunks: left pulmonary artery, right pulmonary artery trunk. Okay, into the two lungs, this deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle carried to lungs. So after that, another blood vessel, important blood vessel, that is pulmonary vein. Pulmonary vein, the pulmonary vein carries the oxygenated blood from the lungs to left auricle. Okay, next, very important artery, largest artery, aorta. What is aorta? This is the artery which starts from left ventricle and it carries the oxygenated blood from the left ventricle and distribute to all parts of the body. Okay, and we also studied the structure of arteries and veins, and the different scientists. Who are they? First Fabrizi, then William Harvey, then Marcello Malpighi. William Harvey explained about the arteries and veins, main blood vessels, and the Malpighi explains about the smallest blood vessels. They are called capillaries. Okay, if you take the arteries, arteries start as big blood vessels, main blood vessels, and end in capillaries, and end in capillaries, thin and small. They supply blood to each and every cell of the body. Okay, they start as main blood vessel and end in capillaries. What are they? Arteries. Whereas veins, they start as capillaries and end in main blood vessels. Like this. start as capillaries and end in main blood vessels. So the pressure will be more in arteries compared to veins. Okay, when the veins are prolonging from heart to the body parts, their diameter increase, so the pressure will decrease. Whereas arteries, as they start from the heart and reaching the cells, the diameter will decrease, they become thin, so the pressure will be more. And arteries receives blood directly from the heart when they pump. But whereas veins, they collect blood from the different parts of the body. Okay, so the pressure will be low. Okay, that is also one of the reason. And arteries does not possess any valves inside. But whereas veins, they possess valves which regulate the backward flow of blood. So okay, we ended the discussion in the last class that how the swelling occurs in the blood vessels. Okay, and two activities also we have come across. So let us start today's class with a few questions. Artery walls are very strong and elastic. Why? Artery walls are very strong and elastic. Why? Because arteries receive blood directly from the heart. So lot of pressure they have to sustain. So that's why the walls of the arteries are strong and elastic. Next, another question. Why we compare arteries like a tree which divides into smaller and smaller branches? Yes. So what I told, arteries start as main blood vessel and ends in capillaries. The capillaries are very thin and root-like structures, root hairs like. Okay, they are having many branches just like tree. Okay, if you see the tree, a tree also main trunk will be there. This trunk is divided into branches, isn't it? Like this. As the tree proceeds from bottom to top, okay, it become narrow. Here also, arteries also start as main blood vessel and end in capillaries. Okay. Next. Last question. The lumen size is bigger in vein when compared with artery. Why? Because the veins receive blood from the body parts. So, if the lumen is big, the blood is easily passed through it. So, when they reach the heart, they become narrow. Okay? So, here, the lumen, the blood receiving from these veins, they are very thin blood vessels. Or capillaries, start as capillaries veins, so easily the blood will be collected through its narrow end, and finally they open into the heart, vena cavae, directly into the right auricle. So the lumen means the space in the veins is more compared to the artery. Okay, so today's class we will study about the cardiac cycle, means functioning of heart. Okay, internal structure of heart is completed in the last class. So let us proceed to functioning of the heart. Human heart starts beating around 21st day during the embryonic development. Okay, till the end of life it will continue. If it stops beating, it results in the death of a person. Means the embryo in the 21st day stage itself, the heart start beating, pumping. One contraction and one relaxation of atria and ventricles is called cardiac cycle. One cardiac cycle is equal to one contraction and one relaxation of auricles and ventricles. It is called one cardiac cycle. Okay, the first one, we start with the imagination that all the four chambers of the heart are in relaxed state. It is called diastole. Two terms you have to remember, systole and diastole. Systole means contraction of the heart. Diastole means relaxation of the heart. Let us assume the four chambers of the heart are in relaxed state. It is called joint diastole. Okay, so here see, all the four chambers are in the relaxed state. So it's a imaginary relaxation of atria and ventricles. Next, the blood from vena cavae and pulmonary veins enters the right and left atria respectively. Here, the blood from all body parts, deoxygenated blood collected by the vena cavae, that is anterior vena cavae and posterior vena cavae, they opens into the right auricle. At the same time, the pulmonary vein, it collects the oxygenated blood from the lungs and opens into the left auricle. So right auricle receive deoxygenated blood, left auricle receive oxygenated blood. Always remember, right chambers of the heart filled with deoxygenated blood, left chambers of the heart filled with oxygenated blood. So now in the third stage, the atria contract, means upper chambers will contract, forcing the blood to enter into the ventricles. So always the blood move from auricle to ventricle, but not from ventricle to auricle. Okay, valves are present here. Okay, in the right auricle and left right auricle and right ventricle are guarded by tricuspid valve. Through tricuspid valve, the blood from right auricle enters into the right ventricle. At the same time, when the left auricle contracts, the blood from left auricle enters into the left ventricle through mitral valve or bicuspid valve. So in the third stage, contraction of the atria results in the filling of ventricles. The blood is filled with the ventricles are filled with blood. Right ventricle filled with deoxygenated blood, left ventricle filled with oxygenated blood. Okay, so when the ventricles are filled with blood, they start contracting and the atria start relaxation. Okay, when the atria relax, ventricle contracts. When the ventricle contract, when the auricles contract, ventricles relax. Means during relaxation stage, what happened? The chambers filled with blood. Okay, so auricles, when they relax, they receive blood. Auricles when contract, ventricles relax and ventricles receive the blood from the auricles. Okay, next, on the ventricular contraction, due to the pressure and blood, the blood moves into the aorta and pulmonary artery. Okay, as we studied that, pulmonary artery arises from the right ventricle and aorta arises from the left ventricle. Okay, when ventricles contract, the deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle enters into the pulmonary artery, and when the left ventricle contracts, oxygenated blood enters into the aorta. The aperture between the atria and ventricles is closed by valves. Now, these apertures, which are guarded by right auriculoventricular aperture is guarded by tricuspid wall. Left auriculoventricular aperture is guarded by bicuspid wall or mitral wall. They close. So, when those valves close, automatically the blood from the ventricles enters into the blood vessels. Okay, when the valves are closed, forcibly we can listen to the first sharp sound of the heart, lub. Okay, lub, dub, lub, dub. These are the sounds made by the heart valves particularly. Okay, so you see the picture here. The contraction of the atria and flow of blood into the ventricles. Ventricles receive the blood. Now here, the contraction of the ventricles, auriculoventricular valves close. And when the auriculoventricular valves close, means tricuspid valve and bicuspid valve, when they close, a sound is produced that is called a lub. The blood flows into the arteries. Pulmonary artery and systemic artery or aorta. So here what is happening? Auricles are the distributing blood vessels. Whereas veins are the collecting blood vessels. They collect the blood and opens into the auricles. Whereas these arteries, they distribute the blood from ventricles to body parts. Next, in the cardiac cycle, the third image, that is a contraction of atria and flow of the blood into the ventricles, we have studied. Now, fifth stage, when the ventricles start relaxing, the pressure in the ventricles is reduced. The blood which has entered the arteries tries to come back into the ventricles. So it is prevented again by means of valves. The valves which are present in the blood vessels are closed to prevent backward flow of blood into the ventricles. So now we can listen to a dull sound of the heart, that is dub sound. Okay, so here it is a tricuspid valve, it is the bicuspid valve, which is guarded by auriculoventricular apertures. And here, semilunar valves are present. The valves which guard the opening of the pulmonary artery and systemic artery valves are present. Those valves are called semicircular valves or semilunar valves, half moon shaped. When they close, because to prevent the backward flow of blood, always the valves will guide the flow of blood in only one direction. Okay, so the blood, as soon as the blood is pumped into the arteries, immediately the valve present in the starting of the arteries will close, so backward flow of blood can be prevented. So that at the time of closing those valves, semilunar valves, a dull sound is produced that is called dub. Lub, dub, lub, dub. So these two sounds. Okay, so when the heart receives, when the ventricles receives blood from the auricles, immediately the valves close, tricuspid valve and bicuspid valve, at that time lub sound is produced. When the blood is pumped from ventricles into the arteries, again the valves present in these arteries will close, at that time dub sound is produced. Okay, one heartbeat is equal to one lub, one dub. The atria are filled with the blood and are ready to pump the blood into the ventricles. So once again, at the when the ventricles are contracting, auricles are relaxing. When the auricles relax, they are filled with blood. Okay. So now, when the ventricles contract, what happen? The blood is pumped to the body parts, and at the same time, auricles receive the blood. Okay. Like this, in a cyclic manner, it takes place. That's why it is called a cardiac cycle. Repeatedly takes place. Okay, the sequential events in the heart, which are cyclically repeated, are called cardiac cycle. The sequential events in the heart, which are cyclically repeated, are called cardiac cycle. Okay. The cardiac cycle includes an active phase, that is called systole, and a resting phase, it is called a diastole. Okay. Systole and diastole of atria and ventricles results in the pumping of blood. The whole process is completed in approximately 0.8 seconds. The time needed for ventricular contraction is 0.27 to 0.35 seconds. See how much less time. The time needed for atrial contraction, it is 0.11 to 0.14 seconds. The time needed for ventricular contraction is 0.27 to 0.35 seconds. Okay. In 1 minute, 70 to 80 times the heartbeat. One heartbeat is equal to one systole plus one diastole. A systole means contraction. Diastole means relaxation. The contraction and relaxation. The contraction, dub sound is produced. Lub sound is produced. Relaxation, dub. Okay. So here, the time needed for this contraction of auricles, 0.11 to 0.14 seconds. Whereas ventricular contraction, it is 0.27 to 0.35 seconds. Okay. Hence, naturally the blood is pumped into the blood vessels at regular intervals. The tissue will not receive the blood continuously, but in the form of spots, gaps, little gaps. When we keep our fingers at the wrist where the artery is passing into the hand, we feel the pressure of blood moving in it. So that is called a pulse. Okay. The rate of pulse will be equal to the number of heartbeats. Already we have conducted the experiments which shows that the rate of heartbeat is equal to rate of pulse beat. See here, in the figure you can see relaxation of ventricles, the closing of atrial valves. Okay, ventricles are relaxing, atrial valves are closed here. Pulmonary artery and here actually the valves are present. So there are four valves are present. Okay. So when the ventricles relax, so these atrial valves, 1, 2, tricuspid valve and bicuspid valve, close so that the blood will be filled. So here let us know some facts. That is, some animals, their weight and the weight of the heart and the number of heartbeat, number of beats of heart per minute. Let us compare. Blue whale is 1.5 ton, means 150,000 kgs the weight is. The weight of the blue whale's heart is 750 kgs. But the number of beats per minute, the blue whale heart is only 7 times. The size of the heart is 750 kgs, but the number of beats per minute is only 7. Elephant, it is 3000 kgs. And the weight of the heart is 12 to 21 kgs. And the number of beats per minute is 46 times per minute. The human beings, 60 to 70 kgs weight, approximately, an average. The weight of the heart is 300 grams. And the number of beats per minute is 76 beats per minute. If you take a smallest bird, that is a coiled bird, it is only 8 grams weight. Its weight of the heart is only 0.15 grams. But the number of heartbeat is 1200 times per minute. So what does it indicate? As the weight decreasing, heart weight as well as the organism weight, the number of heartbeat is increasing. Okay, because the surface area is more to supply the blood, so more beatings required. Okay, children. So cardiac cycle, what is cardiac cycle? The cyclic process of systole and diastole is called as a heartbeat. One systole and one diastole is equal to one heartbeat. Okay. The whole process of heartbeat is completed approximately in 0.8 seconds. Next, circulation. The circulation of blood. Now, the heart contracts, blood is pumped into the blood vessels. So, how the blood is circulated? There are two types of circulations observed in the animals. They are single circuit circulation and double circuit circulation. Means the number of times the blood received by the heart and pumped by the heart is called a circulation. If the heart pumps two times the blood, then it is called as a double circuit circulation. Most of the higher vertebrates, double circuit circulation is observed. Okay, in lower vertebrates like fishes, single circuit circulation is seen. We know that the blood flows in the blood vessels. To keep the blood moving, the heart pumps it continuously. The blood that is pumped by the heart reaches the body parts and comes back to the heart. But the course taken by the blood is not the same in all the animals. It is not same in all the animals. Let us observe. Here the figures are given. Single circuit circulation and double circuit circulation. Start from any point in the figure and move the direction. Let us see, note down the parts which are in the way in cyclical form. Okay, here the two A and C figures are given. The A represent a fish circulation chart. C represent a mammal. here see the blood, so here the organs, gills, body parts, heart, three parts mainly. Here in the mammal, lungs, heart, body parts. Okay, so here in the fish, the blood collected from all body parts, received by the heart, only two chambers, one atrium and one ventricle. So as soon as the blood received by the atrium, it is pumped into the ventricle. From the ventricle, directly the blood is pumped into the gills, the capillaries of the gills. So the oxygenation of the blood takes place in the gill pouches, and immediately that oxygenated blood is again pumped back to the body parts. Here the blood is moving in only one direction, okay, from body parts, heart, from there to gills, directly to the body parts. This kind of circulation is called single circuit circulation, single circuit circulation, or single circulation. Next, in the second figure, in the mammals, if you see the body parts, these red capillaries represent the systemic capillaries, okay, and here the blue one represents the veins. From the body parts, deoxygenated blood is collected and opens into the right atrium. There are four chambers are there here: right auricle, left auricle, right ventricle, left ventricle. So right auricle receives deoxygenated blood, from there it passes to the right ventricle, from there it passes to the lungs through pulmonary artery. So this circulation is called pulmonary circuit circulation. The circulation of the blood between the heart and lungs is called pulmonary circuit circulation. And next circulation is there. After the blood received by the lungs, the blood gets oxygenated, and from there pulmonary vein carries that oxygenated blood into the left auricle. From the left auricle, oxygenated blood passed into the pumped into the left ventricle. From there the systemic artery carries the oxygenated blood and supplied to body parts. Okay, so this is called systemic circuit circulation, means the circulation of blood between the heart and body parts except lungs. Okay, so it is called the systemic circuit circulation. So here the blood is pumped twice, hence it is called as a double circuit circulation, one between the heart and lungs, another one is between the heart and body parts. Okay children, so this is about the double single circuit circulation. Next, so compare the two flow charts and answer the following questions. Here some questions are given. How many times did your pointer touch your body parts in figure 11.A? How many times? Only one time. Whereas in the figure 11.B or 11.C, how many times? Two times. Okay, next, how many times did your pointer touch the heart in figure 11.A, that is fish? How many times? Only one time. Okay, whereas in the figure B or the figure C, how many times? Twice. okay? One is from heart to lungs, another one is from heart to body parts. Next question. How many times did your pointer touch the respiratory organs in figure 11.A? That is in the fish. It touched the gills only one time. Okay? From heart to gills. Whereas in the figure mammals, heart, how many times? The mammals, how many times the respiratory organ is lungs? Okay? So here, twice. Isn't it? From heart to lungs. Again, from lungs to heart. Okay? So this kind of circulation is called double circuit circulation. Whereas in the fish, single circuit circulation, only one time the blood is pumped from body parts to gills and from gills to directly body parts. Whereas here the blood, okay, final conclusion. From your observation it is clear that in figure 11.8 in the fish, blood flows through heart only once to complete one circulation. So it is called single circulation. If the blood flows through heart only once for completing one circulation, it is called single circulation. Whereas in the figure 2, the blood flows through the heart twice for completing one circulation. So it is called double circulation. Okay, the blood, here the circulation of blood we are counting. Okay, in the figure 2 in the mammal, the blood flows twice for completing one circulation, so it is called double circulation. Okay children, this is about the cardiac cycle and the circulation of blood. Please read the textbook. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for receiving latest updates.